Hello everyone, welcome to another video about GammaRay. I am Giuseppe D'Angelo, I work at KDAB. In this video, we're going to talk about bindings. Bindings are a main feature of QML, and if you don't know what a binding is, please take your time and go watch one of the videos linked in the description. It is a link to our QML intro series, where we explain what a binding is in great detail. But in a nutshell, a binding is one of the fundamental features of the QML language. Whenever we have a property of a given item that is referencing a property of another item, then the two create a binding. They get bound together in such a way that when one of the two changes, the first one gets updated automatically for us by QML. It is important to understand sometimes when a property is bound to someone else, which one is this target property. The idea is that sometimes we may have unexpected results and have an item which should be updated because we think it's bound to something, well, actually it isn't. Or maybe it's simply bound to the wrong thing, so we have to fix some binding in outside our code. I'm going to show you some examples here, and I'm going to use GammaRay in order to visualize what are the bindings involved in all these examples, and so we can understand how can GammaRay help us debugging a few bindings. Okay, so for the first example I have here for you is a very simple example. In this example, I'm going to show some text and a rectangle immediately below it. Here it is. And as you can see here in the code, I'm setting the width of the rectangle to be the same width of the text. This is clearly visible here on this line. And what this means in QML is that the two properties, the width of the rectangle and the width of the text, are bound together. Whenever the width of the text changes, the width of the rectangle is updated in the consequence. So indeed, I can go down here, actually I should say up here, inside my element, and for instance, delete some characters or write some other characters. And you can clearly see that the rectangle's width is updated together with the text width. So let's use GammaRay to visualize this binding and to understand how the binding inspector works inside GammaRay. I'm going to launch GammaRay over this little example. So GammaRay is found here. Here it is. And I'm going to tell GammaRay to attach to my running application. In order to visualize bindings, I need to be inside the Qt Quick Scenes tab here on the left, and then I can select which element I want to inspect the bindings of. So in this case, I want to inspect the bindings over the rectangle. Okay, so I just select the rectangle. And here on the right, I got a tab that says bindings. Well, guess what? That allows us to inspect the bindings of the rectangle. So here it is. Here I see that the width property of the rectangle is bound to something. Okay, that's the current value. And it's telling me that this binding is actually a given depth of 2. I can expand this depth. So here what I'm seeing is that the width property of the rectangle is bound to the width of the text element. And something I did not notice from my source code is that the width of my text element is actually bound to something else, to the implicit width of the text element. So this is what GammaRay is telling me about that property, and pretty much whenever the implicit width changes, that causes the width of the text to change, which causes the width of the rectangle to change as well. Let me show you another example again regarding bindings. In this one, I'm going to show an animated image and have some more complex expression for the binding itself. What do I mean by that? Here I got this little example in which I have an animated image that you can see here now on the screen. This image is animated nicely. And on the bottom of the image, I've got this frame counter, which is increasing repeatedly. And next to that frame counter, you can see that yellow-red bar moving from the left to the right, and again from the left to the right, and so on. So what is that little yellow bar? That red bar is just a rectangle. It's defined here inside the source code. And what's it defined to be is that the x of that rectangle is some complicated expression, as you can see over here. I'm not going into detail about the expression, but the important part is that this expression is referencing other properties. It's referencing the width of the rectangle itself, the width of the parent, the current frame of the animation, the frame count of the animation. These are other properties. And as such, this whole expression is a binding towards those properties. Whenever those properties change, this expression gets reevaluated and we get a new value for the x property of the rectangle. And that's what's making this rectangle move left to right, right? What's actually changing is the current frame of the animation. So we get a new value there, we redo the calculations, and we end up with a different x. So let's visualize this one as well inside GammaRay. I'm going to launch GammaRay again. And I'm going to open this application inside GammaRay now. Okay. And now I'm again in the Cute Quick Scenes editor. And what I can see here, again, are all the elements inside my Cute Quick Scene. And let's say I want to be focused on that little movie rectangle. So I just need to find it. And it's this one right here. Okay. And as you can see here on the right, I see that the X property is changing over time. That's the part of its own animation. It's moving. But I can also go into the bindings pane and I clearly see the X property here. And I can open up that X property and I see all the other properties this property depends upon. Okay, so since there is a binding which is formed there, you see that the X does not depend only on just one other property, it depends on number of properties, it depends on the animation current frame, the frame count, the parent object, its own width, and so on, right? So why do I need to inspect bindings? There are at least two different kind of mistakes or two kind of problems that bindings can pose sometimes. The first problem is if we have a chain of bindings which is too deep. What do I mean by that? I mean simply that we may easily create a sequence of bindings where we have a property of one element bound to a property of another element, bound to a property of another element, and so on and so on and so on. When a chain is so long, whenever we change one property towards the root of this chain, this is going to cause a cascade of binding updates. Given the right circumstances, or I should say the wrong circumstances, what could happen is that whenever this cascade is updated, your application may stutter, you may see some frames being skipped, and the reason for that has to do that with the fact that Qt Quick has simply to redo so many calculations along the way. So GammaRay can visualize the depth of these chains, and therefore if you're suffering from this kind of problem, you can start chasing down these cascade of bindings and think about whether they make sense. Maybe you can bypass a few steps, maybe you can restructure your code in a better way so that you don't need to update so many properties all together in one go. Another kind of problem has to do with so-called binding loops. Once more, if you don't know what a binding loop is, please watch the video that I'm linking in the description. It is probably one of the first mistakes that everybody does when we play together with QML. What is a binding loop? As the name says, it means that you have created a loop between bindings. You have bound one property to another property, and then the second property bound back to the first property. Okay, this is a bit too simple. Maybe you have a property A, a property B, a property C, and you somehow formed a loop between them, right? These loops can have arbitrary sides. And actually, the bigger they are, the more difficult they are to chase down. If we create such a loop, all we get from QML is a warning on the console telling us you have created a loop. And now it's our job to figure out, wait a second, where is this loop? And how do I figure out what are the properties involved inside this loop so I can break the chain and open up the loop? Again, GammaRay can visualize this for us. So I'm going to use yet another example here. This example is coming again from the intro QML material. So what I have in this example is something which looks very simple. I got a rectangle, okay? This rectangle is black. And inside this rectangle, there is an image, okay? Which is showing just a gradient. So what I'd like to achieve here is that the rectangle has the same sides of the inner image, while at the same time, the inner image fills the parent completely, but leaving a little bit of margin. So what I wrote here is this. I said that the width of the rectangle should be the same width of the child, that is the image. The height of the rectangle should be the same height of the image again. And also the image should fill the parent. Now this code contains a binding loop. It's not clear where it is, because I'm not seeing any property which is being referenced twice, but indeed there is, if you want, an implicit binding loop. Specifically, since the anchoring has to fill the parent, that means that the image has to have the same width of the parent, and I'm also saying that the parent has to have the same width of the image, right? So now we're stuck in this circular reasoning, where the parent has the same width of the child, and the child has the same high width of the parent. How do we break this loop? We can't. Indeed, this code has a bug, and if I run this code, what I get from QML is a warning. Yeah, as you can see down here, I'm going to raise this a little bit. As you can see down here, all QML is telling me is that there is a binding loop associated with the property width and another binding loop associated with the property height. And my actual application does not work either. Indeed, my image is not filling the rectangle. As you can see, there is a white border around it. And if I try to resize it, all I get is more warnings. So let me do exactly that. Yep, the image is not filling exactly the rectangle, and I get more warnings below there. How do I figure out what's wrong here? Well, this is a kind of a simple example, but as I told you, these examples can go out of hand in more complex applications. Luckily, we have a tool, GammaRay, that shows us the binding loop. So I'm going to launch GammaRay once more in this very example here. I can launch GammaRay here from this button, and I'm telling GammaRay to attach to the running application. So here I have my rectangle with an image, and let's say I select the rectangle and I go back into the bindings pane, and here I see that there is a loop involved. Where is the loop? Well, I got this property called width, which is a binding chain of depth infinite. Since it's infinite, it means that we have a loop somewhere there, that is, we're going towards the same property again, forming the loop. So indeed, the width of the rectangle is bound to the width of the child, which is what I wrote in the original QML code, if you remember. And the width of the child is back set to the width of the rectangle itself. We have a problem here. We need to untangle this, so we need to fix this code pretty much. For the height, we have exactly the same problem. The binding has infinite depth, meaning you have got a loop there, okay? So you can once more navigate down these properties. You can navigate all the bindings involved until you find the loop, and it's up to you to decide where to cut it. So in a case like this, you can decide either to make the rectangle bound to the image and not vice versa, or you can use some more advanced property for sizing, as Jesper is showing in his video, namely things like implicit width and implicit height, which is what I probably wanted in this particular case. That's it for this video. As we have seen together, GammaRay eliminates a good part of the guesswork which is associated when something goes wrong with bindings. If you like this content, don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you get notified when we publish more videos like this one. In any case, thank you very much for listening, and see you next time.